Well, hey there, rock stars. Sarah Rock and Robbins here, coming to you live for another prospecting tip of the day. Who's loving these tips as much as I love sharing them? Go ahead and give me some love or some comments or some hearts. I want to share this teaching with a lot of energy and excitement to start because it's going to be a really hot topic for today. As we get started, let's go ahead and get acquainted. If you don't mind, real quick, share with me who you are, where you're tuning in from. I would love to warmly welcome you. If it is your first time watching, either live or by replay, go ahead and share a number one in the comments below. Because again, I would love to warmly welcome you. Now, I want to warn you ahead of time, this is going to be a really hot topic, sure to help you to power up your prospecting and network marketing. So you're going to want to click share right now and share this right to your team pages for a little virtual viewing party, a chance for a shout when you share. Because remember this, guys, the more who know this information, the greater your team will grow. All right, who's ready to rock their network marketing business? As you're introducing yourself, I would love to go ahead and get acquainted, and for first-time viewers, tell you a little bit more about who I am so you know who's yakking at you today. I am Sarah Robbins, a former kindergarten teacher turned network marketing top leader. I am the author of the best-selling book, Rock Your Network Marketing Business. You can find on my site at sararobbins.com or Amazon. I'm also the creator of the CD series, the Rockstar Recruiting School. This is my entire success system for network marketing, and my new one for leaders, the Masterclass Edition, all of which you can find on my site at sararobbins.com. Thank you, Naomi, and everybody else who has been sharing. As you guys know, I come to you weekdays and share with you a daily prospecting top tip. They're super short and sweet, but let me tell you guys, they are a surefire way to rock your network marketing business that comes from 11 years of experience building a billion-dollar global sales team. I personally recruited over 300 people myself, so let me just say, I know my stuff, all right? And I'm super excited to share it all with you. Today's topic is going to be hot, and it really helps us to roll in today's time. Today, we're going to be talking a little bit about why we work, a powerful way to tell a story in network marketing. All right, guys. So first and foremost, I want you to write this down, or better yet, type it in the comments below so you don't forget. Facts tell, stories sell. In network marketing, facts tell and stories sell. Today, I want to hone in on one powerful way to tell a story that's becoming very popular on our team, and it's through interviews. Are you guys ready? I know Oprah built a billion-dollar brand on interviews, so why can't we do it too? Now, it's one thing to tell your story from time to time on social media in network marketing. We're going to be really focusing on social media today. I encourage you highly to post your why at least once monthly so people that are coming on your page now and again or new friends that you're making always see why. Remember, it's such a small chance that they see you in the newsfeed anyways, and it always helps to refresh your story because as your income grows, so does the impact that you make, right? It makes on your life, but also in other people's lives too. Now, as always, I recommend focusing on meaning, what the business is doing for you and what it's allowing you to do versus money. It helps you to stay compliant, to stay out of the way of the regulators, but also to tell your story in a way that really encourages people from the heart to want to come to you and learn more. Do you know that the majority of my 300 people that I've recruited, most of them came to me and they came to me online? So I'm going to teach you how today, okay? So again, it's one thing to share your story from time to time. I do recommend that you share your why, that you do those vulnerable posts. And maybe you shout out with a little tagline, you know, vulnerable post alert. You know, I was scared. I was afraid. I was about to lose my home, or I was wondering how I could stay at home with my son. And I kept searching for another opportunity, and I'm so blessed that I found the way. Here's what I found. This is what my business is allowing me to do. Your why and your what, right? But it's another thing to showcase other people's stories too. So you're mixing in fresh and fun and inspiring stories that may engage different people that maybe won't connect it to you as a formerly shy kindergarten teacher who maybe, you know, I started in my 20s. There's other stories that I can tell in the company too. And here's the cool thing. They don't have to be on your team. You know, if you don't even have a team, maybe you're a team of one. They can be your upline, your sideline sisters or brothers, your power partners, whomever. So I'm going to teach you how we've done this through a really popular way that's growing on our team. And it's through interviews. And I see a lot of people calling them Why We Work, and they're doing them on Wednesdays. So Why We Work Wednesdays or something similar of the sort. Now, here's a little bit how it works. So I'm seeing people across our company that are basically interviewing people on Facebook or Instagram Live. Okay, so they're going live on Facebook or live on Instagram, or better yet, if you have a smartphone and an iPad and you can go live on both, you can leverage both of your audiences. And basically, they're creating promotional material up front. So a little post that they're putting on Facebook, a little post that they're putting on Instagram, a save the date to their online community, all of their friends, followers, and fans for, you know, save the date Wednesday at 5 o'clock for Why We Work. And if it's going to be on your page, tell them where to go, at Sarah Robbins One on Instagram. If it's going to be on somebody else's page because you're being interviewed, but you still want people to watch, go to my friend's page at Sarah Robbins One to watch my interview live. Because remember, facts tell, stories sell. That's how we sell people without selling on social media. We tell stories of what the business and the products are doing for us. So basically, it's set up like this. Let's say that I was interviewing you. So I would open up and I would go live just like I am right now, but we'd have a little split screen, right, of you and me, and we're talking and we're chatting, we're interacting on Facebook Live, Instagram Live, or both. And basically, I'm going to open up and welcome everybody, thank them for tuning in, remind them of my why, and then introduce you, Susie Q. And I'm going to say, so Susie, tell me a little bit about your why. Why did you start your business? Why were you looking? And then Susie shares her story from the heart without mentioning the company name, because that will help you to stay compliant, but also pique curiosity so they don't just go to your website, right? But they have to contact you to learn what it is that you do. So Susie shares her why, and she shares why she's excited, why she was looking, why she joined, but then she shares her what. She shares her what, and she talks about what the business is doing for her. So I would say, you know, now share your what. Now that you've shared your why, share your what. What is the business doing for you? How is it making a difference in your family's lives or in the lives of other people? And again, steer clear of money claims, guys, and instead focus on meaning, what the business is allowing you to do or what it is doing for other people, okay? Then after that, I would say, that's awesome, Susie. So tell me a little bit about what your favorite product is and the results that you're seeing so far. And again, how do you say it without saying your company name? Well, I just absolutely have fallen in love with my acne line without saying the product, right? You know, immediately I started using it. I saw immediate results. Redness was going down. Swelling is going today down. And today I'm acne free. I just love it. And it's caused me to fall even more in love with the company. And then she's going to pass it back to me, and I'm going to say, well, thank you for sharing your why. And again, I want to remind our viewers today of mine. You know, this is why I started, and this is why I love what we do. Thank you so much for tuning in to Why We Work on Wednesday. Stay tuned next week for another leader sharing their success story with you. Guys, interviews are so powerful. Again, think of it this way. Oprah built a $1 billion brand on interviews. People are obsessed in today's world with success stories. In fact, whenever I find somebody successful, the first thing I ask is, you know, tell me a little bit about your background. Tell me about your journey. Like, I want to know, because of course, I'm always curious about how people got there. I mean, I'd love to do a podcast on just how you built it, right? I mean, wouldn't that be super powerful? She built her brand, Larry King. He built his brand on interviews. I want you to think about doing these on social media, and we'll talk about how in just a minute, but I want you to think about what they do. I call it the three E's. What it's going to do is it educates. Rhonda, thank you for sharing this with your team, and thank you for everybody else who's been saying they've been sharing. It helps to basically edify. It will edify the person who you're interviewing. The second thing that it will do, it will encourage your team of people as they're seeing continuous success stories. The last thing that it will do is engage your online audience who says, oh my gosh, you interviewed a teacher this week? I'm a teacher. I would love to ask her what her business is. Think about that. So virtual events, guys. You know, I know a lot of you do virtual events. I do too. They were the number one thing that I implemented in my business last year. In fact, I'm going to train you exactly how I did these virtual events on my August 8th social media summit. Who's registered for that, by the way? It's going to be incredible. But they're one element. But think about adding in. Let me just stop and say this. Virtual events, it's one element of telling the story, but they're private pages, right? So you have to get people to agree to watch. But these interviews are another element to add. They're going to be shorter stories. Virtual event is longer. Great content for people who are considering. But these shorter little segments through interviews, they're just gonna pique curiosity, especially if people see you're consistent doing them weekly and they're public. So sometimes people out of their curiosities or scrolling their phones at the end of the night might be like, oh, a quick five minute video, why we work, these inspiring success stories from top leaders, you know, around the globe, maybe not even say in our company. I see her posting these all the time. I love success stories. I'm inspired by a success story. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm going to tune in. These stories are going to engage your prospects and keep your business top of mind. So let's talk about the who and the how. Who do you interview? You interview anybody in your company who's willing to tell a story. It doesn't have to be your team. It can be your upline. It can be your crossline, guys. It could be your sideline sisters or brothers. And you say, you do one for me, I'll do one for you. I'll scratch your back, you scratch mine, right? How do you do it? Well, guys, if you're scared, if you don't know how, if you'd actually like to see all of this in action, I want to invite you to my social media training that's happening Wednesday night. You thought this tip was juicy, guys? I just got done literally today. That's why I might look a little bit tired. Doing over 100 slides, an hour's worth of inspiring content and ideas just like this, but 10x. That I'm going to be sharing with you on my social media summit on Wednesday night. Who's registered? You can go to sararobbins.com now on the store tab to get registered and click on the social media that sells summit of 2018. It's going to be at 9 p.m. Eastern, but here's the thing. If you can't make it live, that's okay. Sign up anyways because I'm going to give you a replay. All companies are welcome. As you know, just like today's training, it's totally generic. You can use it in any single business. But guys, I believe it's going to be, thank you, Naomi, for posting the link. I believe it's going to be one of the most talked about trainings in network marketing. I truly do. We're going to talk about posts, power posts at work. So you're going to see examples of people who are top recruiters in their company and how they're doing free posts, no online advertising on Facebook and Instagram to power prospect, supersize their sales, and rock their recruiting all online. We're going to talk about live video. So if you're stuck on even the technicality, like I don't even know how to do that. We're going to actually show you how, but for those of you that are advanced, we're going to give you some great technique too to really rock live video. We're going to talk about virtual events. I'm going to show you exactly how I do mine. It was the number one thing that I implemented in my business last year. Guys, the world is living on social media today, and who you know and what they have to recommend online is more influential now than ever before. So you can either put this in the that's too hard box or I can't afford it. But instead, I'm going to say, you can't afford not to, guys. It's real. It's relevant. It's how big brands are advertising today. So if you want to build a big brand and business in network marketing, make sure you register right away. Our last class, the Recruiting Masterclass, did sell out. So the closer we get, we're going to sell out fast. Register now at sararobbins.com on the store. And while you're there, you can pick up the Recruiting Masterclass. I added a few more sessions on demand, so pick it up there as well. All right, guys, who's coming on August 8th? I hope to see you there. And if not sooner, on tomorrow's prospecting tip of the day. Did you love this? What did you guys learn? Go ahead and shout out in the comments below. I love to hear your takeaways. Don't forget to share this with your teams. You want them replicating this. And for now, I want to thank you so much for tuning in. Have a great day. God bless and goodbye for now. And rock on, rock stars. I'll see you here tomorrow.